I know, everything. Okay, look, there are things going on at other places that are not the leaky cauldron.
Yeah.
I promise you.
Going on.
Well, yeah, like it's chicken bad day, and I don't want to miss the rest of it. Also, I saw a rather Britishly handsome chap.
Yeah, that's you probably don't want to go talk to him. That's
I don't want to talk to him. So I'm going to go to the front window because obviously this guy's been a bit of a prat from everything I've seen. Can I see him out in the street?
Can you right now see him out in the street? Yeah, he's headed over towards.
The owl post.
The owl post.
I'm gonna look at him and aim my wand and go, ridiculous totalis.
Oh, what do you do to him?
He looks a bit more troll-like.
Oh no! So Jack's walking along and like his nose grows out into a pickle nose with warts on it, and he starts shrinking down and hunching up into a troll shape, and then he like looks down at his hands and he's like. What? What's this? Who did this to me?
Well, Ghana, you're probably going to want to see this.
Oh.
You played a prank on an old
happy chicken bear day from one deranged lunatic to another.
Thank you. That's
he does look better.
I wish I could play that bear all the time. He deserves that.
This is ridiculous.
It will take him a while. That spell is of my own invention.
Oh, even better.
So.
And always do something about this. I can't. Oh, do it now! I just want to interrupt this to tell you guys that you and chat can, during Chicken Bear Day, also devise your own pranks to play on the Wizards of Diagon Alley. Back to the game! I forgot to tell you that earlier. But I bet Dom was all over it, right, Dom? Nope.
I don't know the mechanics of how that's supposed to work.
Oh, you don't?
Yeah, no one.
Okay, well, it's just like this prank. She came up with a spell that she wanted to cast. You tell, like, what's the prank is, this is the thing that happens to somebody. If it's going to break the game, I will make it happen to somebody walking past. But if it doesn't break the game, it can happen to whoever you want.
Oh, somebody already played a prank on my character, thank you.
Yes.
It was lovely.
It's an awful prank.
It's how we celebrate Chicken Bear Day. In memory of Benedict Chicken Bear. That great
guy.
Not so great wizard.
Oh, great Benedict Chicken Bear.
Chicken Bear Batch.
I'm chicken. So I don't usually go outside on this holiday. I just happen to need books today.
I mean, honestly, do you go outside very often in general?
Does going to work count?
No.
Right.
All right. So I admit I missed you.
I knew it. Ladies, there is something more pressing right now. There is a murder. We don't know. And what is going to happen, dear? Since Jack was here, did he tell you anything about the case?
All he told me is that everything looks like it was me, and that they're still pursuing more evidence.
Unfortunately, Renat looks like he might be right, but I feel like someone is trying to use you somehow.
You were an aura, were you not? Mm-hmm. Well, where would you start if it was someone else?
Maybe, can I try reading your palm?
Sure.
Why not? See if I can get a past
Mine's
event.
Palms? We'll just know everything about you.
I guess so.
Except for those couple of closed doors, which I will not be forgetting.
No. I can see, I can look for past events, just major things, so I can't get specifics, but I can try and see if something major happened last night. All right. Why not? More information, better.
Yeah. Okay.
Filthy rich, 5 children.
Can't remember how we did this last time.
I do remember.
Okay.
So.
I want to read her palm.
You're going to read her palm?
Yeah.
Did I say that you could just read palms whenever you wanted without rolling?
I don't remember. I know Crystal Ball was blind roll.
That's sure.
I couldn't remember what.
Does it matter if they win?
No, I don't think palm reading ever.
I think palm reading was
palm pretty. Palm reading's too general.
Yeah.
So, yeah, palm reading's fine.
Crystal ball, I can only use to see the future, so.
Right. Palm reading, you can only see the, well,
I can
you can
see
only see the, like, broad strokes.
I can see their broad strokes of your life, so if anything happened, super major.
Reader palm!
No, go ahead.
Do you not know anything about palm reading?
I know her lifeline. Your lifeline has 2 splits here, and I know that stuff.
That means you die twice and come back.
Yes!
Excellent.
It's gonna be a good story. I was like, I don't remember how we did this last time.
Right. Okay. So you look down a lifeline.
Life.
You're looking for the closest to the current event is where the lifeline and the heart line cross over each other.
So this little right here?
Yeah. And so you look at the lines immediately before. You're looking for a major line that crosses that lifeline. That's all you're looking for, right? Major event. Very recent. You see one big slash, and then a bunch of small slashes that get bigger and bigger and bigger until you reach the current day. But nothing outside of that.
So
it's not, and like nothing gets as big as that other, that bigger slash.
But you have one huge, huge event that has happened, and I'm pretty sure it's something you're not telling us about.
When? Can you tell how recent?
It's in the past, like at least 5 years.
Right.
And then the more recent stuff was just, it started off small, but it kept getting bigger and bigger. Probably, and my best assumption is that would be relating to what's been going on with your bloodlust.
Where are you guys? You guys in the kitchen or are you in?
We're in the, like, the back, near the back door.
Oh, is anyone looking out the window?
Well,
roll a perception check!
Everyone, I was looking out the window because I cussed that guy.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, that's true. Where are you?
I'm keeping an eye on that because I like to watch my handiwork.
Oh, yeah. And he is, like, he's doing everything you could dream of. Like, he's, like, trying to pull his nose off. He's, like, stamping and cursing.
22.
22. Mm-hmm.
26. 26?
Yeah.
Wow,
you guys are very perceptive.
I'm not.
You know what? You're still a little Jamaican.
I'm trying to find where it is.
It lasts a long time.
Where is it on the sheet?
You guys notice if you look out the front window of Morgana's store, you see a cute little 15-year-old girl come up and try the front door, but it's locked. So she just kind of shrugs, goes, oh, I guess I better go study my astrology, and heads off down the road.
Is it the girl that I?
That is the girl you saw. If you must remember her name, she's a 15-year-old Hufflepuff, and her name is Trini Flapperly. You never asked that before because you didn't care about the students.
We didn't.
Well, we cared so much.
We cared to save them.
Yeah, save all the others, too.
Is she the one who I saw was basically just going to die? Because I read the palm of one, it was basically they're going to die.
No, that was a Slytherin in wit.
Should we invite her in while she's here?
We should follow her, because this kind of looks like what I saw, her wandering down a street.
Oh, so we're following.
I think we should follow her or stop her.
Stop her and go talk to her.
All right.
I'm just going to open the door.
I don't know what she's going to
tell us. Hello. Yeah. Hello. Hello.
I think we need to make contact.
Actually, we are open. And my, you look familiar. Do you go to Hogwarts?
Oh my goodness, I do go to Hogwarts. Oh, I do know you. I do know you. You were the ones who came to Hogwarts and you told me about the dark arts and the black magic, and you told me to stay in a room. And yes. I did for 3 days. I was very hungry and I had to pee in the corner.
Well, that's a very sensible place to pee when you have to. So good on you.
It was terrible.
But you survived. Isn't that amazing?
And we stopped it.
We did.
We got rid of all the monsters.
The monsters? There were monsters? What? What?
Well, no. They look like monsters. It was dark arts. I mean, obviously.
You are
guys.
You are a Hufflepuff,
so
right?
I'm scared now. Yes, I'm a Hufflepuff. Oh, I have so much homework to do. But right now we've got the day off for Chicken Bear Day.
What are you doing?
It's the greatest day of all the year, except for Christmas, which we celebrate even though we're wizards.
That was a lovely song.
One of the greatest wizards I ever met. You met Santa? Of course. Oh my God. Albus and I used to go and party with Santa every now and again too.
Of course you did.
He throws the best parties.
That's please amazing. Describe for us.
Parties at a Santa party. Well, through. It gets a little wild. Those elves, I tell you, they have a lot of energy, let's just say. They can party all night long. All night. All night long. All night.
Well, darling, what brings you to this muffin shop?
Well, I just wanted a muffin because I wanted to eat it. I like eating muffins, especially magical ones. They're so fun.
Well, do you want to can have a muffin?
Sure. Which one would you like?
Oh, well, I like all of them so very, very much. But I suppose that the one I like the best is all of them. I want all of them. I can't make a decision.
So you want one of each?
And I think the least we could do is probably give a... some for free. That's up to you. You run the business.
Right. Well, you can pick one.
You're sure she's important?
What do you mean?
Oh, just we were talking about someone else. We were in a conversation.
She's 15 and young and bright and has lots of dreams.
My mother says that I'm very important.
Oh, who's your mother, dear?
My mother is Sandra Lavely. And she's a housewife. But she also sells things on Etsy, which doesn't exist yet because it's 1995.
Wizard Etsy.
Like precursor Etsy at fairs. She goes around and she knits things and she loves me very much. And she loves me and my two brothers and my dog very, very much.
Who's your brothers?
Well, that's George and Huckleberry Beverly.
So unimportant. Okay. So... dear,
what do you mean unimportant?
We're just wondering.
All very important. Just.
Oh, sorry.
Well, again, we were having another conversation. She was just referring back to that, nothing to do with you.
Oh, yes.
Oh.
It was adult conversation.
Oh, I'm never supposed to listen in on adult conversations because that's what my mommy and daddy do in the room by themselves.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
That is correct.
Quite true.
And
why did we invite her in again?
Because she had a vision of
her. So where are you going today after the muffin shop?
Oh, well, I guess nowhere really.
Were you going to go see the creatures fight?
No, that's terribly illegal. My mother would be very upset with me.
But really, where were you going?
I don't want to say.
Why?
Then it won't be good.
What?
I don't know if that's how that works.
Don't be mean to me! You brought the Black Dark Arts into Hogwarts!
No, we weren't.
I told those auras all about it!
What?
There's some very nice auras here, and they asked me if I knew who Morgana Fyrstrom was, or something like that.
Hellstrom.
Whatever. I'm a Hufflepuff. I can be wrong about things.
I guess so.
I'm afraid of ghosts and sheets with holes in them and regular sheets.
I told him. They didn't even think I was that important. They were asking everyone if we knew her, Morgana Hellstrom, and I said, oh, I know her. He had a picture, too, to show us in case we didn't know her name. As I didn't know your name. Because you didn't tell me. That's very impolite. My mother says you should always introduce yourself to somebody and you need to give them a very good handshake. And then when I said I knew you, he was very interested in what I had to say and so was his friend. And I told him all about the dark arts and that you had the dark arts in Hogwarts and that you left me in a room for 3 days and that I peed in a corner.
We stopped the dark arts at Hogwarts.
What?
It's gone. We finished.
I guess that's why I have to do my homework again then.
Yeah. We got the monsters
that's
gone.
That's not a good thing.
That is a good thing.
What was his aura's name?
Was it a Britishly handsome chap?
Oh, he was definitely. I mean, not real handsome, but like handsome for Britain.
Right.
And he knew Shakespeare.
Of course.
He was very smart. If I was older, I would totally like him.
Oh.
Well, listen.
When you're older, you probably won't like someone like him.
What? Why not?
Oh, your
you're
taste
like
may
nice
change.
Boys. Mm.
That's true. Oh, I used to love marshmallows, and now I don't like them so much anymore.
Oh.
So, but where were you going, though?
Where was I going just now?
Where are you going to go after the muffins? Are you going to have fun?
Around. I was just going to have some fun.
Can I use sense motive? I have Legilimens as well. That's my backup option after sense motive, so that maybe I can needle it out of her without delving directly into her mind.
Yeah.
Don't you have interrogation skills also?
I do not.
I
have bluff.
Didn't I add
I
that
have
to your
sense
sheet?
Motive.
Oh, no. I see just intimidate.
But sense motive would be more...
Yeah,
finding out if she is up to something else.
Evil intentions?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Plus 4, so 21.
All right.
So, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being saintly Mother Teresa intentions, and 10 being Voldemort Dark Lord intentions. Mm-hmm. She's at like a 5.2.
Ooh.
My dear, I hate to be that person, but I don't think you're being completely honest with us. And we did save your life.
And got That's you some true. Free muffins.
Yeah. Here. We just gave you free muffins.
And didn't
I
pick on you for
I
being a Hufflepuff.
One free muffin.
No, one of each.
Did you change your mind? Well,
not
I got all of them.
One free each, but one free muffin and you can buy the rest if you like.
See, that's what I heard earlier, and it's not enough muffins to get me to spill my guts, is it?
Morgana, give her a few more muffins.
It might be worth it.
Your shop
you
is practically
so?
A health hazard
muffins?
As it is.
How many muffins do you need?
Oh, are we playing hardball? My father loves this game. 3.
All right, you can have 3.
I won! 3 whole
See,
muffins!
It wasn't that
I'll never
hard,
be able to eat
right?
so many!
Well, tell
okay,
us, I mean,
fine,
honestly.
I'll tell you, but only in exchange for 3 free muffins, the greatest coup any student has ever won!
Yes, you
Absolutely.
Have challenged
You're
us all beyond huzzah! Reason, and we're very
you
impressed.
A prize.
Brilliant.
You, house cup to you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Well, I really did very much want to pull my own prank. Chicken Bear Day, so I was just now looking for some place to play a prank.
Oh, well,
what kind of a prank were you hoping to pull?
Well, I was thinking that I would make somebody try to open the door and it wouldn't open. No,
brilliant.
It's not good. I can tell from your faces that it's not good.
I just would recommend Gina here is a master prankster,
and she enjoys
might
it a lot.
Be able to help you with something better.
Some students are unteachable, ladies.
She might be able to help you.
That was not a nice thing to say right in front of me.
Do you have a particular door in mind?
Well, it was Chicken Bear Day, so haha, I said a thing that I didn't honestly mean.
Oh, there's so Chicken Bear of you!
Yes, right,
oh,
right.
Oh, you're so good at Chicken Bear Day, I'm not.
But you could be.
So we were talking about a door that doesn't open, but didn't you have a vision of a door?
There was a wall that opened.
Was there
a
door in particular you had in mind?
No, I was just going to find somebody trying to open a door and I'd quickly lock it.
Do you
right
have
before they could open it?
Anything else from that vision? Like, whereabouts? There was stuff
it
around
was
the door?
In our store. And
was there something
blurry.
On sale there?
No.
What? What are you talking about?
Oh.
It's just, we're setting up our next prank.
Oh, I love pranks.
And there was a store that I wanted to go to, but I'm having a hard time recalling what it looked like.
Where That's were you
very
going?
Strange.
Where were you going next? I mean, you said you wanted to play a prank, but one of the very first things you should know about pranks is you have to be able to pick a target. You have to know where you're going. And I have to imagine you at least had an inkling of which direction
well,
you wanted to head in.
I guess that's because of where I came from.
Where did you come from?
Well, I was at the Owl.
Post.
The place with the owls, yes.
The place with the owls. Because that's where they keep all the old newspapers. And mm-hmm. I was going through old newspapers looking for articles about old pranks. And then I got caught up reading other articles instead. There was one that was really interesting about this man who was caught sneaking into the ministry. And there was other ones about Mary makeup.
Delightful.
Did you notice any of the papers had a clipping missing?
Well, I didn't look through all of the papers.
We should do this at the Owl Post. Let's pull a prank at the Owl Post.
Yes.
What a great idea.
What a great idea. The outpost is such a great place because so many people go there.
Yes, people have to That's go. You have people
like
to
we will,
all the time.
Like we will do right now.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Let's go.
Warping the young.
I do.
At least you get to have some fun, right?
I've already had my fill of Chicken Bear Day with that one handsomely British chap and his face now.
It was quite good. I think that should happen more often to him.
It probably should be permanent, let's be honest.
I agree.
Well, it all depends on, we'll see. We'll see. Depends on how clever he is.
This.
Escher designed it.
I'm so good at maps. This is a shelf. This is like the little cubbies.
Mm-hmm.
With all of the cubbies. where mail goes into. And there should be the other things, but they were hard to draw.
And then child.
Mm-hmm.
Child. She looks very childlike.
All right, my dear. I'm sorry. What was your name again?
My name is Trini Flappery.
Trini, which doll are you planning to use to pull the prank?
I didn't know. Should it be this one? Should it be this one right here?
The front door is a bit obvious.
Okay.
Maybe.
But do you feel drawn to another door in here?
There are no more doors in here. Only the front door.
I think that would work just fine while we look through.
Oh.
You could start practicing there.
Okay, I will practice. So
yes.
You don't.
Anyone who tries to
open the door, I will lock it, and they won't be able to come in, and they'll think that we're closing. It will be such a good prank for Chicken Bear Day.
Oh, good job!
I will be back to check your work, but I find students have to learn and find the inner prankster on their own.
Oh, wonderful!
So you stay here and you do that.
Okay.
Brilliant, brilliant. Can I still award points, I wonder, to Hufflepuff? 10 points to Hufflepuff.
I am too innocent to know that can happen. Okay,
I told her she'd get the house cups. So.
Wouldn't that be hilarious?
And you all act like I'm a horrible person to children.
Well, I think you've been rubbing off on us.
That's probably true.
I never said I liked most people.
Okay, so here's what happens. You guys come into the owl post, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's a table over here that's your newspapers. There's the person who works there is sitting there.
This guy.
Oh, yeah,
perfect.
Sure. Yep, exactly.
Tentacles and all.
As we proceed as a group, I am going to go muffliato, which is going to keep nearby people from listening to our conversation.
Ooh. Fantastic.
Excellent. So over here, so these are the newspapers. Over here.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see where Trini has been through some newspapers, and then there's some other folded papers that haven't been touched or were cleaned up. Mm-hmm. And they're on those sticks.
She's by the door.
You know those sticks that they used to put newspapers
on? Yeah,
yeah. Yeah. Those great sticks.
Now I feel very old. Mm-hmm. So that old stick newspaper.
Yeah. They still have those.
No, I suppose in some places
certain
they
libraries
might.
To just put them
if they don't have the microphone.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was like, wait, I'm...
It's all right. Mm-hmm. It's right, young one.
I had to think of what it looked like, but yeah, I've seen that at libraries.
Mm-hmm.
In a documentary.
Well, I would have seen the newspaper
sort
article
of young.
If we're looking for the one that was in that guy's pocket.
Mm-hmm.
And I probably would know at least where, like, what year that was from in
okay.
time period. So I would start looking there.
All right, you notice that the newspapers from that time period have not been recently disturbed.
Hmm. Recently?
Can I find that article?
You sure can.
And it's untouched.
Oh, no, it's been clipped out.
Oh.
But not recently.
Mm-hmm.
That's... This is it. This is the one.
Oh, okay.
But it looks like...
It's been a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, this...
I don't know what that means.
Touched today.
It just means no one has moved it.
So this was something that was planned, not just recently. This is something that's been...
Planned?
He had that in his pocket for quite some time then, potentially.
Did you ever have fans or anything? People who...
Still do. People recognize me all the time. It's very strange.
Yeah. Would he have maybe had a do you think there's a potential he was related to someone you hunted down, or if you were having a discussion with him last night, could it have been about a previous case?
I suppose. I mean, that's not really something even now that I would do, but
well,
if you were drinking,
necessarily you,
right?
And
that's
not the drink. I don't think it was drinking.
I think there was something in the drink.
Something. You think she was poisoned?
I don't
something.
Even know. Someone who's talented enough wouldn't even have to put something in a drink.
That's true.
I don't know. Which?
And today she blacked out, and she hadn't had a thing.
What was the article about?
I don't think the drink. I don't think
the article
the
that
alcohol,
you that he carried in his
a potion in the drink.
Okay, so the article says
mm-hmm.
the article is like it's a picture of Morgana, a slightly younger Morgana, like sort of posing with her wand, and the article headline is
what a priss.
Hero Aura, Auror.
Mm-hmm.
Auror. Hero Auror captures evil wizard. And if you read it, it is about the time that you caught, what's his name? God, why do I give you names and then forget them?
You gave me this name?
I gave him to me a long time ago. He might even be gone.
Oof.
Give him a new name.
Me?
Dom Flotsam.
Inspired by?
For her Meister Meisterburger.
Dom Flotsam.
Dom Flotsam.
I like it.
Well, all of a sudden, all the lights go out, everything shuts down, this is all over.
No!
We're never heard from again.
I'm sorry, it was an homage!
No! Oh, no,
things are being destroyed!
Studio up in flames.
Oh, not that! Don't hit that!
So angry, so angry.
We need that!
Angry, you're an angry elf.
He must be one of those South Pole elves.
South Pole elves.
Someone gave me a sock and I'm all mine, baby.
He's his own elf.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Yeah, I brought that wizard in.
He's an Azkaban.
Yeah.
I mean, how long ago did you bring him in?
How long ago was this one?
This is like 4 years ago.
It was about 4 years ago.
Is there any way, especially someone who's working at the ministry, might be able to find out if he is still under Azkaban lockup? I
mean, probably.
Yeah. That would be information.
It might be worth it to check.
We could check, but it wasn't him. I mean, I would recognize him.
Polyjuice.
Yes.
It could be possible.
But you didn't see anyone. So how do you know it wasn't someone who got to you? And we're very focused on it being in the drink. It might not have been.
It might not have been. I'm just saying.
There's a lot of options. I'm just saying this is the only lead we currently have.
It could have been someone. He could have been doing this to you, or that Fiera person. Do you think she could be involved in this?
Well, I wouldn't have thought so until recently, until Hogwarts.
There are still Death Eaters about. You never know.
Yes, there are. Yes, there are.
I don't know. Uh-oh. He can't even get through the stairs. We
totally can. Because he goes sideways. onto the... Oh, this one's just dropping pieces left and right. I'm breaking him!
That's what happens when he tries to go down the stairs.
Nope. Iron Tusk is going to kill me. Mm-hmm. Don't tell anyone that that happened! Don't tell anyone that that happened!
Is that
rude? Whoa.
Totally.
This guy can...
Loud noises!
I love Riggles.
You know what? We're going to go with exactly what this guy is. A giant, muscly barbarian appears at the top of the stair, wielding a bloody axe over his head.
Morgana, stash the rest of that paper. Let's take it with us.
All right.
I can put it in my bag.
Okay.
And he goes, whoa!
Good prank.
That's not one of ours, chap.
What? Initiative!
Oh, initiative. Oh, where'd my paper go?
Oh, she's gonna roll fast.
Ooh, oh. Can you beat a 16? Can anyone beat a 16?
No!
Yes, I can. I have a 20.
Okay, you guys win. You go first. Me and my dice.
Yay!
Back. We're doing a simplified initiative to spend less time doing it. So if they beat the monster, they just all go first. Go first.
Right. Trini, it's time to stop practicing Coloportis and get out.
What?
Go out of
just
the door.
Just leave. It's not a prank. Just leave.
This might hurt you. We
don't
want
dark
you to get
hurt.
Dark arts. Oh no.
Is this a monster?
Yeah, it's a barbarian.
Barbarian.
Right.
Okay. So you hold off on attacking as much as you possibly can.
Well, I'm going
to reset.
Yeah, that's what I thought at this point.
Shall I?
Yes, go for it.
Ridiculous Totalus, and now his armor and his weapon look a bit like the Halloween foam pieces.
Naturally. Naturally.
Oh, fantastic.
All right.
Hopefully that's at least a little jarring.
I'm going to try to cast Bombarda. worked out.
Exploding one.
Yeah.
Did you note an extra point in that since you did it successfully?
I forgot Bombarda.
You get a bonus to your damage.
That is important.
Okay. Or if you're
I wrote down all the others.
Okay. Just making sure. That's what I thought.
I get. It becomes a level one, right?
Guys.
Is that what happens?
While you're deciding what to do about this giant barbarian, Knight Steed gives Terabella a Revelio.
Ooh.
So for the Revelios, we're gonna use these gold dice coins. You can hold on to it until such time as you need to know if what somebody is saying is true or false. You also get, and I happen to have, ooh, it's of your choice.
Oh, goodness. What do I have in this bag?
Mace.
I do. I already knew I had that, though.
Is that bear mace?
It is. Let's get this monster.
Okay.
He's like, So this
is good quality bear mace that has like a 30-foot radius.
Yeah.
You get him right
in front of him. I mean, I'm right
totally
there.
Are.
So.
Oh my gosh.
Action monster.
He's got a foam axe.
My eyes. Barbarian.
Okay.
So he's blinded by the mace, and the tears are streaming down his face, and he's just swinging
mind
wildly.
Mind you, because it's hilarious.
Can I flipendo him then?
Yes, you can.
Maybe not. Let's see, what did I get?
So for the successful cast,
I'm laughing so hard, and I accidentally
like
do this, and you're like, oh.
Yes, that's what happens. All right, I didn't offendo him, but I did mace him, so
wait,
you're up.
So wait, what did you roll?
I got a 6.
You got a 6? I feel like you just cast a dancing spell on somebody else in the party.
Oh, good.
Who Da-na-na, got it?
That guy.
Nope. Can that guy's sexy? Not in your party. Nope. He's hiding behind this bookshelf. You can't see him.
Okay. Who wants to dance? Dance, monkey,
roll.
Dance.
Just roll a
d4. 1, 2, 3. Oop.
Lamo.
I can do it. I believe in
now
myself.
Drop.
I believe in myself. I believe in myself. I believe in myself.
3.
This isn't funny anymore.
I'm so sorry.
I get a little soft shoeing.
That was amazing. Yes.
You sprinkle some sand on the floor first.
Obviously.
I love you.
But not right now.
That's what's going on in the background. Well, the monster is incapacitated by mace.
I'm going
what
to
are
cast
you do?
Bombarda on him.
Sorry.
15.
Okay.
Level 2. And it was 2d4?
It was.
Where did I put that extra d4?
There it is.
Yep. 1, 3, 4 damage.
Okay. 4 damage.
I will cast Incarcerus.
Okay.
Incarcerus!
Ooh.
19, yes. Yes. Well, I don't know why I rolled because that's one of mine. I just wanted to roll for the fun of it.
And you got 19.
There we go. Sure, why not?
I know, right?
So Incarcerus, he's blinded by mace. Mm-hmm. His weapons have been turned to foam, and now he's tied up by magical ropes.
Like you do.
Mm-hmm.
Like you do. This monster is just...
Yep. So, we want to throw him outside?
Can we still do things? What's happening?
Do you just want to knock him out?
Yeah.
Leave it.
How do we knock him out? What do we want to knock him out with?
I wonder if we can use his own force against him to get him to fall over with perhaps a fanged frisbee to the face.
Do so.
What would you like me to roll?
Dexterity. This is pretty specific.
12?
Is that with your bonus?
With dex, yes.
It's pretty specific. I think you just bounce that one off of his head. Just make him sad. Oh, okay.
Reroll.
This is in the right place. Beat a 14.
Nope.
Okay, one more reroll and give me a different ugly die.
ugliest one you have.
Ugly die.
Ooh, that one's gross. Yeah. I want that.
This one?
Yeah, yeah, it's a bit pooey. Mm-hmm.
Trying to find.
Ugh. Nope.
Not pooey enough.
More poo.
All right. Well, I guess it just bounces off his head a bit. I'm sure it's annoying.
This guy's incapacitated. Anyway, it's Sunday. Can't do anything to you.
I just really wanted to throw a fanged frisbee at him.
Could we just cast? Which one is it? Which one is the one where we? Not. Oh yeah, levi corpus, and just float him outside.
Sure you can.
So that one I actually have to roll for, and it is
level
3, which means I have to get 15.
Mm-hmm.
No.
All right.
But he's tied up and he's foamy. Do we need to do anything else, or can we leave?
You're just gonna walk out with this monster here? Is that your plan?
I feel kind of bad for the owl.
I do feel bad for the guy back there too. I don't know. I'm just saying. All right, fine. Let me try something with him. Okay. I'm gonna bombard and just do a little mini explosion on him, and see if we can just make him poof. I hope I don't do any too much damage to the store, though. Knowing me. All right. That doesn't do anything. Well, let's.
Okay.
Wait, that's my reveal. I don't have any. Oh, wait.
Yep, you
thanks,
have
guys. That's terrible. Terrible.
Wow.
It's just one of those nights.
Those are like opposites with your die rolls.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on over here.
Yep.
You're sucking all of the luck from every other die in the area.
Seven, so something else terrible. What, do I get another bird? Do I get water?
Oh,
what do I get?
Bought me good dice.
I get a Lumazumus out of my speed of light. Light shoots out. Little sparks.
Lumazumus. Speed of light. So light moves at the speed of light.
Well, I don't know if that was quite helpful, but it looks neat.
Didn't it? That was like a little light show.
Yeah.
Okay, are we in combat still, or?
Nah.
All right.
You can't do anything.
It has worked before. I've got this. Levi corpus, boot to the head.
All right.
You guys are making me do this. I hope you realize.
I like how it's like
so
a major
good at plot knocking
point.
People out with a boot to the head. Tip him over, he's incapacitated and unconscious.
All right, well.
Where did that guy come from?
What a good question.
There's an upstairs.
Let's go up there.
Actually, while they go upstairs, I'm going to cast Legilimens and see if I can't find out where he came from.
On the barbarian?
Am I able to?
You go into his mind and he's just like, food! Rawr! A lot of like images of like campfires and woods.
Grossly familiar, but all right. Well, that didn't work. Let's go upstairs.
You go upstairs, and who
look,
goes
there's
up, gets
been
up there
out
first?
In the woods, all right.
Me. You get up there first, and as you get up there, you see like the walls slide together and seal.
Oh, did you all see that?
Did you see that, for the second time?
I mean,
this isn't the same color paint of the wall.
This isn't the same color paint of the wall, but, you know.
You can remember the color of the paint, but not anything else.
It's blurry.
She'd recognize it if she saw it.
It could be a deja. What was that? Deja oops.
It could be a deja oops.
So if I was there, it would look exactly like it. It's just. Nothing about divination is completely accurate.
It's bloody awful. Which reveals hidden secrets or magical properties? Is that what they're casting?
They're casting Revealio that reveals if people are telling the truth. Okay. Your Revealio would just be like, is there something magic here?
So I want to cast on the wall, Specialist Revealio.
Okay.
And it's level 2. That's an 18 plus 2, 20. I think plus 2. Yes.
Yes. So you cast Revealio on the wall, and it Revealios that there was a magical spell just cast here, and it's like dissipating because it's done.
Can we tell what spell?
Yes.
It was?
Make a door.
It's a really well-known spell.
Yeah.
Can we cast the same spell?
Ready. They're getting ready to cast their spell.
Can we
make a door?
Remember in Harry Potter how they had that secret hideout? As the kids had that secret hideout, and if you knew the password, the door would open to you, and the door moved around. Remember that? It's that. It's that same kind of room.
Dang it. So, we're not going to be able to, basically, unless we just guess the right thing.
Right.
Start yelling words at it.
No.
Well, could it be...
Open sesame!
Right.
That was it! No, it's not.
That's like Hakuna Matata.
Whoever put this together made the dumbest password possible.
Password. 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's what it was. Password. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I had the same combination on my luggage.
0, 0, 0.
0, 0, 0.
It's the factory setting.
PS2s come with that built in, and you have to do that to get the child lock off of them.
Oh.
It's really weird.
That's crazy.
And there's nothing around it. No writing, no anything.
Well, what? So we're here. Mm-hmm. And is it this wall?
I mean, this could have just been
building?
A prank.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
That's very true, especially
with the leaky cauldron?
Barbarian.
No.
Next to it? What is that?
Cauldrons.
Let's try going next
leaky
door.
Leaky cauldrons across the alley.
Oh, that was something else I remembered. There were cauldrons.
Oh, well,
Thank you.
Go to cauldrons next door and see if we can find them.
I named a store cauldrons.
Yes,
and
ma'am?
Then I told you there were cauldrons in it.
There is a store in Diagon Alley called Cauldron. It has
See,
a cauldron in the title.
I thought she said something about cauldrons earlier, and then you're like, no, I can't remember.
No. This is what makes the game fun for me, guys.
I apparently forgot to write down cauldrons.
It's all good. I'm enjoying
divination,
it, is what I'm saying.
Bloody awful.
Well, I was really terrible at it, so I don't like it quite either.
The only person here who was good at it. Mm.
Good?
So, let's go next door. Do you have cauldrons?
But apparently I'm a seer now, so...
I do, but it is also very late. So
yes,
we're not
it is.
Going to
what?
Enter cauldrons. That's where we're going to stop. It's right before we enter cauldrons. Are you going to send Trini somewhere, or is she still following you?
I imagine she wandered
off. We sent her on her way, because she was scared of the dark eye.
I mean,
yeah,
unless
she
was waiting
away.
For us outside.
She would have gone outside and then stood like a
for
puppy.
For 3 days.
Trini, darling.
Yes.
What spell were you using to lock the door?
Lock you.
That is awful. All right, so I will give you a bit of advice and I want you to just go off and practice it on your merry way.
Okay.
Colaportus.
Colaportus?
Yes.
I will practice that.
It locks doors.
That's so great.
They can't even use a Lohomora to get in.
That would be such a good prank.
Yeah.
It would be if done successfully, but I have faith, so enjoy the
have
chicken
fun.
Bear day.
Maybe. Do you have any anything like that?
I have limited resources to pay for them. They're mine.
She could go to that shop.
That's true. Also, if you want to go to the Weasley Wizards Weezers.
Actually, they're still
that's
mail
not
order.
Open yet, right?
No. They are mail order.
This is the fifth year, guys.
This is the fifth year. They're not, they haven't opened the shop yet.
Next year. 96 or 97.
No, but they did have a mail service. Don't help her, but she's already inept.
As you are
nice.
Going towards cauldrons, go into cauldrons, you see Jack, who's now a troll. Headed your way. We are going to stop there. It's something of a cliffhanger. Guys, keep track of the clues you've discovered so that they can build together to a picture that becomes clear.
I wrote down that we have a table reroll.
Yep.
Keep track of your rerolls. You'll get to use them next time.
Yes.
Thank you, chat, for your wonderful participation.
Yes, thank you.
That worked out lovely. I really enjoyed the different ways that you guys were using their activating the different character stuff.
Yes.
Tell us what you're on. What else you're on, guys?
All right. Where we
drugs.
Start? Yeah. Where
oh,
we?
Wait. Not that.
What?
Our next show is February 1st.
February 1st.
We'll be back.
come
back. Miss Adventures will be back on February 1st.
With
you have to find out what happens to Jack.
The mystery demon.
Oh, yeah, the Britishly handsome.
Troll.
Now a troll.
Will he ever not be a troll? Will he be Britishly handsome again?
He's always going to kind of be a troll. Like, let's be honest, right?
Well, let's see. I will actually be back here on Saturday. I will be here playing with Phoenix Dawn Command. We are ending, coming very close to the end of our first season, so please tune in. My character's flair, which had been pretty much murder everyone in the vicinity, has been deactivated because my character's got her stuff together a little more. But now it's called It Wants to Play, and if you activate it, she is basically a giant werewolf puppy. It's ridiculous. And also, I recently joined the Happy Jacks RPG team. They also broadcast on Twitch, and every other Sunday we are playing Vampire the Masquerade, so look them up, and I am playing something vaguely wolfy there, too, because I'm a one-note kind of gal.
You're just so good at being wolfy.
When I don't do it, people are like, oh, but your character's going to, like, get bitten by a radioactive wolf, right? So when I don't do it, people are like, oh, but, So you guys have done this to me. That's really what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm giving you ways to do it for whenever my thing happens. So.
That is true, too. You are all enablers.
Yep. No, next week I'll be on for Lost Brigade Wednesday, 7:30. Every Wednesday, I'm just going to be here in the studio, sleeping.
That sounds awesome.
She's just sleeping in the studio now. Yep. This is where she lives.
Yep. I don't have a home.
We have a pillow and blanket.
I don't go anywhere else.
Well, I also play in Black Bag, which is our Call of Cthulhu game, which will be not this Friday, but next Friday. And then on Mondays, generally at 4, my husband, Jordan Caves Callerman, and I stream co-op games. Right now we're playing Diablo 3. Let's see, tomorrow we have, tomorrow's Thursday, so we have Disorganized Play with Tom Lommel, which is our GM prep game, which is kind of cool.
And it is very cool.
No, Grav's out of town, so we won't have that. But this Friday, we've got TMTO.
Never tell me the odds.
Yes, Star Wars. I love it.
Star Wars RPG.
Yeah.
So much fun.
Yes.
So lots of fun things. Other fun things next week.
So much great stuff on this channel for you guys to
absolutely
consume.
Yeah, and you can subscribe. Subscribing is great.
Subscribe!
Subscribe, please.
Oh, especially if you have Amazon Prime. If you already have Amazon Prime, you get one free Twitch subscription. And then when you sign up, you actually get to give a reroll, which, as you've seen, are very helpful to the player of your choice.
Yeah.
Ooh. So do it, because I did it, and it was awesome, and it's one of the only awesome things I've done in my life. So at least follow that one example.
And we've got Patreon, so you can check that out. You get access to some cool stuff if you sign up for our Patreon. And everything you see here, if you want to see more, you want us to keep doing it, we do it because you guys help us out. So.
Help you.
Yeah, like you notice, like the cameras are better, all that kind of stuff.
Right.
Things improve because you guys help out. So thank you so much.
Keep track of the clues. There are things going on that our players have missed. If you catch it, you can help them solve
or make it worse.
Sooner.
Did you keep track of the newspaper?
And of course,
she's got the newspaper.
If they don't solve it, I guess Morgana is going to Azkaban.
No,
I don't want to go there.
That's bad.
Thank you so much, you guys, for tuning in. We'll see you on February 1st. Good night.
Bye. Oh, wait. We have to do it this way. Here.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Wizardry!